We'll be calculating the pH of an ammonium nitrate solution in this video. Our question here is to calculate the pH of a 0.25 molar ammonium nitrate solution given the Kb of ammonia as 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. Again, remember, if you're given the Kb of a substance that is not exactly what you're solving for, this is where you need to use Kw to convert. We start by writing our dissociation equation, NH4NO3. Again, we're only working with soluble salts here in this chapter. So ammonium is our cation, nitrate is our anion. And again, we're given 0.25 molar of this original salt solution. This one does dissociate in a 1-to-1 ratio. So the concentration of our ions will be the concentration of the salt. If we had a salt that dissociated in a 2-to-1 ratio, we'd have to take that into account to figure out our concentration of ions. Now we know, of course, that nitrate is a neutral anion. It will not hydrolyze. It's the ammonium ion that is going to hydrolyze. Because ammonium is the conjugate acid of ammonia, we predict this to be an acidic salt. Again, always helpful to write that as a note for yourself so that when you calculate pH, you can confirm your answer makes sense. Again, for our hydrolysis equation, because we're starting with a cation, we have to end with the hydronium ion, so therefore this is acting as an acid. We again set up our ice table with our starting concentration of ammonium. Water's not included, products start at zero. This reaction will go forward. Everything changes by a value of X. And now when we're writing our equilibrium expression, we have to remember that we are calculating the amount of hydronium in solution. Therefore, we need to use a Ka expression. We write our equilibrium expression first, products over reactants. And then our equilibrium equation, plugging in our equilibrium values. I don't know the value of Ka yet. Again, I was given the Kb of ammonia up here, which again means that I need to convert the Kb of ammonia into the Ka of ammonium. And again, we already did this in our last video or two videos ago. I'm going to do it again so that we can use unrounded values here. And again, on this one, we technically end up with 5 bar repeating, but eventually round off to a digit, however far out you want to go on that. As long as you go 2 or 3 extra spaces before you round that last place, that's fine. So now this is the math equation we are solving for. Again, we have an extremely small k value, so we can definitely assume that this denominator x is going to go to zero. And in fact, that k is so small that we don't even need to check our assumption. Our setup for x is going to be the square root of the product of our Ka value that we've just calculated times our initial concentration. In equation form, we are taking the square root of our Ka times our initial concentration, the product of those. And here x equals the value of 1.1785 times 10 to the minus 5. Again, that's molarity because it's from an ice table. And helpful to tell yourself what you've just calculated, that this is the hydronium concentration. Since we already know our hydronium concentration, that means we can simply take the negative log of this concentration value, and that will give us our pH. Again, this is acidic, so we expect a fairly low value. This is a 4.93. Again, 2 sig figs in concentration in Kb, so we have 2 decimal places in pH.